Dear students, see the next question from 11th standard Motion in a Straight Line chapter, NCERT exercise problem number 3.9. Okay, so please listen. See this question, it is one interesting question, the based on the relative velocity. Okay, even if you observe the question, you feel somewhat it is difficult and something. Question only become large. But concept is there, you know, I hope you know very well about the relative velocity. If you know the relative velocity, this question answer is nothing. Okay, shall we see the question? See that. Two terms, okay, because already I informed you that all the question based on our practical life only. So please imagine two terms, you imagine any two terms, okay. Your area and nearby some village or otherwise some area going to Erode. Okay, so like that you think. Okay, according to your well-known area. Okay, listen, two towns A and B are connected by a regular bus service. Okay, connected by a regular bus service. So regular bus service means what? They maintaining that uniform time interval. I say, for example, every 1 hour one bus, every half hour one bus, so like that uniformity, okay, or every 10 minutes one bus, like that, okay. So, with a bus leaving in the either direction every 10 minutes, see that every 10 minutes, so we don't know that maybe 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 40 minutes or anything. So, every 10 minutes from A town, say A town, so town A, then this is the town B, okay, for every 10 minutes they are leaving one bus from here, for example, now it started, one bus is leaving, okay, this is the first bus, okay, now after that the first bus is moving here, then another bus will come, again after 10 minutes the first bus, second bus and third bus, okay. So like that, every 10 minutes, one bus is coming from the bus stand. Okay. So in this situation, a man, that is you. Okay. A man cycling with the speed of 20 km per hour. 20 km per hour. So now what you are doing? So let us imagine now you are from A station, A bus stand. Now you are taking the cycle with the speed 20 km per hour from A to B. Okay, I think you say, yeah, means A to B. Okay, bus also every 10 minutes is leaving from the station, from the bus stand. Then you are taking your vehicle, your bicycle only, no, yes, with the speed of, yeah, cycling, it's a bicycle. You are cycling with the speed of 20 km per hour from A station to or A town to B town. Okay, so this is a situation. So in that situation, what you are observing, what will come in the question? You know, comparing with your cycle speed, the bus speed will be high, surely. So every bus from the A station, it will cross you in particular time. Okay, correct or not? At the same time, some buses from B station, it will come opposite to you. Clear? The same situation will come, see that. So, cycling with the speed of 20 km per hour, this one. Okay, cycling with the speed of 20 km per hour in the direction A to B, notice that a bus goes past him every 18 minutes. Okay, appa ivar enna pannudhu, ovvoru bus from A station every 18 minutes. Okay, so every 18 minutes one bus is crossing him from A town. Okay, every 18 minutes one bus is crossing. Okay. In the direction of his motion. In the direction of his motion means what? Now we consider from A town to B town. So A town to B town bus is, you know, so that bus is every 18 minutes crossing him or crossing you. Okay? Okay. from A to B, okay. At the same time, B to A bus also opposite will come in, no? See that, that is of this motion. And every 6 minutes, see that, this bus is every 18 minutes, but this bus is every 6 minutes is crossing because the relative velocity is high, because in opposite direction. So every 6 minutes, every 6 minutes in the opposite direction, the bus is crossing him. Okay, so in this situation, what they are asking, what is the time period? So what is the period T? What is the period T? That means time asking me of the bus service with and with the speed. Okay, the speed they said, it's a constant speed. Okay, because every, for example, every half hour, one bus is coming from the station or in the town with the constant speed. Okay, 50 km per hour means every bus is 50 km per hour. So like that you assume that. Okay, they mention like that you assume that. Okay, so to the bus plying on the road. So now they are asking that time period of the bus service. Okay, from A town and B town, two towns are there. From A town, every T minutes, every T minutes or T time period, one bus is coming from the station. Like that, town B also one bus coming from the station. Okay, now what you are doing? You are coming from the A town to B town by using your cycle with the speed of 20 km per hour. At the time, every 18 minutes, one bus is crossing you from A station. Okay, as well as every 6 minutes, one bus is crossing opposite to you every 6 minutes. So in this situation, what is the time period of the bus service for both station? That is the question. Here important point, the speed of the bus or velocity of the bus is constant. Clear? Now you are going to find what is the time period of the bus. Okay? Here you must focus the relative velocity concept is very, 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 very important. Okay, so we do that. See that. Town A, town B, every T period, one bus is leaving from the station. Like that, every T period, one bus is leaving from B station also. Now you are moving with your bicycle with the speed of 20 meter per second in the direction of A to B. Okay, then every 18 minutes, one bus is crossing from A station. Like that, every 6 minutes, one bus is crossing opposite to you from B station. So in this situation, what is the time period? What is the time period of the bus service? Okay. Now, let's say take that is A to B. Now I take the A to B. First relative velocity concept from A to B. Okay. A to B, one bus is crossing to you at every 18 minutes. Okay. See that. First, the speed of the bus. Speed of the bus, already town A and town B is I mentioned. So bus I mentioned as a small letter B. So the speed of the bus is VB. Okay. So now the speed of the bus, it is comparing with the cycle velocity or cycle speed. So I can write velocity of the bus with respect to cycle. That is VBC is equal to VB minus VC. You know very well relative velocity concept. So VB is the velocity of the bus. They said constant, but we don't know the value. So simply I can write VB minus cycle velocity what? 20 km per hour. So 20 km per hour, then kilometer per hour is a common variant. Okay? Now you know speed of the bus. Okay? That letter only. Then speed of the bus with respect to cycle is what? That is, you know. Now, you know, every time period with the same distance the buses will be traveling. So you must calculate that distance. Priyadilya, so for example, every half hour one bus will come. So this distance will be same. So simply I mentioned the t. So the distance will be the same. Simply I mentioned the t. The time period also will be same. The time period also will be same. The time period also will be same. So now I'm going to calculate that distance. Okay. So now see that distance. So distance covered by the bus with respect to the bicycle in the time interval. The time interval what? So every 18 minutes the one bus is crossing that person. So that time period is 18 minutes. அப்போ டிஸ்டன்ஸ் கண்டுபிடிக்க முடியுமா? ஓகே, அப்போ எப்படி சார் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் கண்டுபிடிக்கிறது? ஸோ யூ நோ த ஃபார்முலா. வாட் இஸ் த ஃபார்முலா? ஸ்பீட் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு டிஸ்டன்ஸ் டிவைட் பை டைம். ஸோ டிஸ்டன்ஸ் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஸ்பீட் இன் டு டைம். ஸோ டிஸ்டன்ஸ் இஸ் பி, ஸ்பீட் இஸ் பி பி சி, தட் இஸ் வெலாசிட்டி ஆஃப் த பஸ் வித் ரெஸ்பெக்ட் டு த சைக்கிள் இன் டு டைம். டைம் இஸ் வாட்? 18 மினிட்ஸ். Clear? So now D is equal to VBC. Already you know what is that? VB minus 20 kilometer per hour into, இப்ப இதெல்லாமே கிலோமீட்டர் பர் ஹவர்ல இருக்கு, பட் திஸ் இஸ் 18 மினிட்ஸ். அப்ப 18 மினிட்ஸ் என்ன பண்ணலாம்? ஹவருக்கு மாத்திரமா? எப்படி மாத்துறது பாருங்க. 16 மினிட்ஸ் 1 hour means what about 18 minutes? 16 மினிட்ஸ் 1 hour னா 18 மினிட்ஸ் how many hour? That is a meaning. பாருங்க, minutes minutes will be cancelled, so hour is remaining. Okay, then again hour is cancelled, remaining kilometer. The kilometer means what? Distance. Okay, so we can say VB minus 20 into what is remaining? 18 divided by 60 kilometer. This is not fulfilled. This is not velocity of the bus completely. Here, VB, I mentioned the velocity of the bus or speed of the bus, I don't know that value. Still, this is as equation only. Clear? So, I am taken as this is equation number 1. Okay? I hope you understand what is happening A to B. Okay? B, A town to B town, that distance is, that bus distance is completed. So, like that, B town to A town, the same idea we are going to follow. So you know very well the velocity of the bus from A town also same, from the B town also same. So the speed of the bus is VB, so I mean right here. Okay, the next step as is going, velocity of the bus B with respect to the cycle from A station, that is here. Like that, velocity of the bus with respect to the cycle, the common equation VB minus VC, but you know very well the cycle and the bus will come in opposite direction. Clear? So in this equation, minus already is there because it's relative velocity, but VC is in opposite direction. So the bus will come to the towards the A station, then cycle moves towards to the B station. So it is opposite direction. So minus of minus become plus. Okay. But in that previous equation, here we can get VB minus 20. But here VB plus 20. That is a difference. Then as usual, distance covered by the bus with respect to the cycle in the time interval. You know, in the previous case, okay, every 18 minutes one bus is crossing. So, for 18 minutes, I calculate the distance. But now, here, every 6 minutes, the bus will come opposite direction. But anyhow, the distance between the two buses will be the same. So, I can write the same letter D. Here also the D, here also D. So, D is equal to, so what will come the formula? Distance is equal to speed into time. Okay, distance is equal to speed into time. So I can write here that the distance is equal to speed, that is VBC into time. Time how many minutes? See that in the second bus, I mean that bus from B station or B town, for every 6 minutes is crossing. Okay, so here the 6 minutes. So now I can write D is equal to VBC. Already you know VBC what? VB plus 20. kilometer per hour into time is 6 minutes. 6 minutes, how to convert it into hour? 60 minutes is 1 hour, means what about 60 minutes? 60 minutes is 1 hour. Okay, 6 minutes, how many hour? That is the meaning. So, minute will be cancelled, hour will be cancelled. So, the remaining BB plus 20 kilometer. Then, remaining 6 divided by 60. Okay, so please students, from A to B, we covered the distance covered by the bus. Okay, for every duration. Like that, distance covered by the bus for every duration. So, both the distance will be the same, because every time interval, uniform time interval, the bus will come from the station or the town with the same speed. அப்ப அது எவ்வளவு தூரம் வந்துச்சோ, இது எவ்வளவு தூரம் வந்துச்சோ, the same distance will be covered, D. அப்ப ரெண்டு equation என்னதான் answer will be the same, distance will be the same. Okay, so what I'm going to say, equation 1 and equation 9, equation 2 will be the same equation. Shall we equate? Shall we equate means what will get? This is possible to get velocity of the bus. Clear? Shall we equate? So listen, we know that A to B, that is equation number 1, and B to A, that is equation number 2, both having the same distance value. So I can write equation 1 is equal to equation number 2. So equation 1, you know, that is creating the same direction with the A station. So VB minus 20 is equal to 18 divided by 60. You know that equation. Like that, equation 2, it will come in opposite direction. So that distance, you know, VB plus 20, 6 divided by 60. This 18 is every 18 minutes is crossing. The 6 minutes is every 6 minutes is crossing. Okay, right. So in this situation, you know, here 60 will be the cancel. So the remaining here 80, here 60 is there. Okay, in 6th table, this is, you know, 1 time, this is, you know, 3 times. So VB minus 20, 3 equal to VB plus 20. Okay, right. Now I need VB only, that is the velocity of the bus. But the velocity of the bus only in the left side, the remaining is another side. So VB is moving this side, so minus VB. So 3VB, then 3 into 20 is the 60. So 3VB minus 60 equal to VB plus 20. Now this VB is moving the left side, so 3VB already is there. VB is moving left side, minus VB equal to 20 is here. Minus 60 moving that side, plus 60. Okay. Now 3VB minus VB. Okay. For total 3VB, lower VB portion, 2VB. Is equal to 20 plus 60 is 80. So VB is equal to 80 divided by 2. 80 divided by 2, how much? 40. So 40 km per hour. So we know that assume the constant speed, it is how much? 40 km per hour. So that value we found now. Okay, but now what is our target? What about the time period of the bus service? See that. So very simple. The time period of the bus service, let's take any equation, equation number 1 or equation number 2. Okay, so I take equation number 2. In that equation number 2, the velocity of the bus value I am going to substitute. Equation number 2 what? Actually I am take as a minutes value, not in hour. So D is equal to VB plus 20 into 6 minutes. I didn't take hour because not that much duration. So every few minutes only bus will coming out, because town only, no. So approximately let's take minutes, not in hour, not in village side. Okay, so every few minutes bus is available, so better I will take minutes value. Okay, so distance equal to what formula? Distance equal to speed into time. So distance equal to speed into time equal to VB, bus speed is 40 km per hour into 20, this 20 value into 6 minutes, that is a 6. Or like 6 minute noises. Minutes. Okay. 6 minutes. Okay. So velocity of the bus 40 km per hour. This T 40 plus 20 60 km per hour. Kilometer per hour is cancelled. So remaining minute only is there. Okay.
Right. So I need this time period only. Therefore, time period is equal to the 40 is multiplied here, moving that side division. So 60 into 6 divided by 40. So 0, 0 is cancelled. 6 into 6, 36 divided by 4. 36 divided by 4. 9 into 4, 36. So 9 time. So 9 minutes. Okay. So now we found that time period, that is the bus service duration, every 9 minutes are available between A and B town. Okay. From A station also, every nine minutes one bus is coming, and B town also, every 9 minutes one bus service is available. Okay, it is a very interesting question related with relative velocity. Okay, I hope you understand this question. Okay.